Okay, let's go ahead and solve a question. Let's read the question carefully, that's extremely important. A rigid tank with a volume of 3 meter cubed. So I have a rigid tank, something like that, right? And I have the volume to be 3 meter cubed. Okay, contains 50% saturated liquid and 50% saturated vapor by volume. Okay, if the fluid is water, I want to double ensure. And the pressure within the tank is 200 kilopascal constant given to me. Find the temperature, find the quality of the mixture. Okay, that sounds silly. Isn't that 50, 0.5, right? Wrong, you'll see in a minute. Total internal energy of the mixture, okay? Total energy, internal energy of the mixture. Okay, so please do not watch the rest of the video. Stop here, try to do it on your own. When you watch me doing it, it's gonna look easy. When you do it yourself, I don't think so. Okay, try to do it yourself. Okay, let's go back. All right, pressure is given to me as constant, so then I will actually more appropriate for me to draw TV diagram. Okay, so I'm gonna draw the steam dome. Doesn't have to be perfect, that's not the goal here, but here's what it says. Okay, and this P is 200 kilopascal. That is given to me. So now the nice thing is I need to go and find where this is, okay? So I know that I'm in between, but the question is, I was joking when I said that, but this is by volume, and the x is defined by mass, and as you will see soon, this will make a huge difference, okay, in terms of the numbers. The x is not going to be 0.5, okay? So which table do I need, have to look at now? As I plot here temperature, it needs to be A4, no? That's incorrect. What I need to look at is I'm looking at a constant pressure line, right? As I'm looking at a constant pressure line, I need to look at A5 that will list it for me, okay? So if I go to table A5, I'm not going to show it at this point, but you will see that the saturated temperature will be 120.21 Celsius. Okay, let's revisit this. So I'm here, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here, I don't know, but I'm in between, right? As you can see what's happening in here. So it's a constant. We talked about this many times, but 120.21 is the temperature over there. It's a constant temperature. And these are pairs. Once I have a saturated pressure and saturated temperature, once I have this, I will be able to obtain it. So the first answer to part A turned out to be fairly simple to me, okay? Okay, in order to go ahead with the quality of the mixture, a typical tactic for these kind of things is to look at the specific volume. That is the most common approach. Because now you can see over here, the volume is given, basically the percentages of saturated liquid and saturated vapor by volume is given, so I know those. So if I can obtain the masses, maybe I will be able to obtain the quality of mixture. So that's my thought process, okay? And I also, when I'm looking at the table A5, when you're solving a question, write down everything that you need because you don't want to go back and forth between the tables and, you know, trying to find it, okay? So I'll go ahead and simply copy the table A5 information over here, okay? Okay, so as I mentioned to you, my thought process. So I have the total, what is the volume of the saturated vapor? That is my question to you. What is it? That's 50% by volume. The total volume is 3 meter cube, so that's going to be 1.5 meter cube. Same thing for the saturated liquid, it's going to be 1.5 meter cube. Okay, and as you know, the definition of the specific volume or for the saturated liquid will be this, right? Divided by the mass of the saturated liquid. Okay, so all right, fine. Note here, I know this. I know this, so I can find MF. That's exactly what I'm going to do. So from here, my MF will be the volume of the saturated liquid divided by the specific volume of the saturated liquid. So I simply use the numbers that is given to me. So I run out of space, but let's write it in here. It's equal to 1.5 meter cube divided by 0.00161. Meter cube per kilogram, right? That's the unit, so you can see meter cubes cancel. I have a 1 over kilogram in the denominator. It will go up as a kilogram, so that's nice. I know I'm doing something right. And you can see what is the mass of it, okay? This makes sense to me. 1.5 meter cube of water okay? It can be saturated, but it is going to weigh quite a big amount, right? So you can see what the number is here, right? It's fairly large in terms of the mass. So we'll do the same treatment to the saturated vapor, and you will see the saturated vapor will be this, again, same thing. So I'll use 1.5 because that is the same between the saturated vapor and saturated liquid. And this is 0.88578 meter cube per kilogram. And this will be a small number, 1.69 kilograms. That makes sense. Because think about this. I have the same volume for that, same volume for, like, think of this as a gas. Gases doesn't weigh much. That is small. And liquids weigh a lot. You can see it over here. This is not a surprise to me, okay? Because you may be thinking, oh, I made a calculation mistake. How come these numbers are that much off from one another, right? Not really. Okay, let's look at the total mass, because I'm going to need it, mf plus mg, so that will be 1413.76 plus 1.69 kilograms, and that is 1415.45 kilograms. And you know what the x was defined as? It was defined as the mass of the saturated vapor to the total mass that I have in my system. The mass of the saturated vapor will be 1.69 divided by 1415.45. I'm just copy-pasting the numbers. And if I plug this into my calculator, I'll get a fairly small number. Okay? What's the unit of x? Unitless. It's dimensionless, right? So I was able to find my x as 0.0012. Extremely close to zero. So where am I? Am I here or am I here? Remember, it goes from 0 to 1. So then I'm fairly close to here. Okay, I'm maybe somewhere right over there. Okay, that is the quality of my mixture. Once I obtain the quality of mixture, actually part C is fairly easy. There's no difficulty there. The reason is I have a formula for it. U is equal. And I drive this formula plus X times UFG. So UF, I know 504.5. plus 0.002012 times the UFG that is directly given in the table to me. If I plug this into my calculator, it will be fairly close to 504. That makes sense to me because I'm fairly close to the pure saturated liquid region. Okay, so this becomes as 506.93. If this was a multi choice, my weekly quiz, would you mark it? And you think I did real well, and I'm 100% sure I would put this into the answer to kind of fool you a little bit, okay? But this is not the answer. So why am I saying this is not the answer? Because it asks me the total. It doesn't ask me the specific internal energy. This is the total. This is the specific energy of the system, not the total. If this was a stationary, this will be the total energy, not just total internal energy, but total energy will be this. M total times the lowercase u, and that will be 1415.45. that is my mass of the total system, multiplied by 506.93, and just for a good measure, kilojoule per kilogram. This is kilograms cancel. I got myself kilojoules, and when I punch this into my calculator, I get 717.533 kilojoules. Okay, or I can write this as 717.5 megajoules. Okay, now you may appreciate why we are studying fluids in the thermodynamics class. In theory, I can obtain this much of work or energy out of it. It contains a lot of energy. So this is just pretty much, you can see in here, it's almost like this, right? So just the liquid has this much of energy contained in it that we can tap into. Okay, I think that's gonna do it for me today. Thank you. Have a nice day.